Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. This is Tariq Amin, lecturer, Department of English, Kuwait University of Science and Technology, Kuwait. A very warm welcome to the course of Communication Skills. This is video number 2 of the lecture number 26. And in this video number 2 of the lecture number 26, we are going to discuss formal letter. The lecture outlines of today's class include formal letter and parts of formal letter. Now, let's discuss formal letter. In the video number 1 of this lecture number 26, we discussed what is letter. We discussed the two types of letter, formal letter and informal letter. And we discussed that formal letter is a letter that is usually addressed to a person who we don't know on personal level, where informal letters are usually written to friends or to family members. In order, when we want to get in touch with them, we write informal letters. And in informal letters, we use informal language and we don't follow any prescribed standard format. Whereas in formal letters, we follow standard format. We use formal language. We take great care of spelling, we take great care of punctuation marks, grammatical structures, and spelling mistakes as well. So formal letters are usually addressed to the persons who we don't know on personal level, and they are usually written down in order to get a job, or in order to complain something, or in order to get some knowledge, in order to require some information. So in this video we are going to discuss formal letter and the format of formal letter. Formal letters are letters to people whom we don't know on personal level. These are usually addressed to the people whom we don't know on personal level. They are unfamiliar to us most of the time. Now, these are formal letters are used to find out information. We can use them to find out information. Apart from this use, we can also use formal letter in order to apply for a job. When we want to apply for a job, we write formal letters. We don't write informal letters because our purpose is to get a job. And when our purpose is to get a job, we write formal letter, in which we use formal language. And we also use formal letters to make a complaint. This is what we discussed in the video number 1 of lecture number 26, that apart from writing formal letter for a job, we also write formal letter in order to make a complaint. We also use formal letters for complaining as well. Heading, these are different parts of formal letter. The very first part of a formal letter is heading. And heading is the heading consists of your address, but not your name and the date. So heading consists of your address means the address of the writer, the address of the sender, but not your name and the date. In heading, you use your address and the date, and you don't include your name. Telephone numbers and email addresses are not usually included here, but they are acceptable. In formal letters, the telephone numbers, email addresses, etc., and different IDs are not usually included in formal letters, but they are acceptable. You can write them, you can include your email address, you can include your cell phone number. They are acceptable, but they are not usually included in formal letters. Sit in a block format. The heading goes in the top left corner of the page. Now, what does this block format mean? There are three standard formats. One is block format, one is modified block format, and one is another semi-modified block format as well. And so when you sit in a block format, the heading goes in the top left corner of the page. For example, this is your page. This is your page. So your heading starts from this point, from the head, from the top left corner of the page. We can see that the heading starts from the left top left corner of the page. This is an example. World 1, 2, 3 Elm Ave, Hartree's Valley, ONM1N. This is address, and this is date. In the heading, we include address and date, and we can see them in the example. Address is there, and date is also there. This is date, and this is address. Another second part of formal letter is inside address. The inside address consists of the name. It consists of the name and address of the person to whom you are writing. In the heading, we don't include name, whereas in inside address, we include name. It consists of the name and address of the person to whom you are writing. It includes the name and address of the receiver of your formal letter. You should try to address the formal letter to a specific person. You should address your letter to a specific person, to a particular person. You should know his or her name. However, if you don't know their name, at least try to include their title. If you don't know their name, try to include their title. For example, let me give you example from cast. For example, nowadays the Vice Chancellor of Quart University of Science and Technology is Dr. Sardar. Now, we know the name of this, of the Vice Chancellor of Quart University of Science and Technology. When you address your formal letter to this person, when you are writing your letter to VC Cust, so you should address it to you should address it to him. You should write his name. However, if you don't know their name, at least try to include their title. If you don't know the name of the Vice Chancellor of Quart University of Science and Technology, you can include his or her title. And we know that the head of the Vice Chancellor of Quart University of Science and Technology is Dr. Sardar. We should write his name. But still, if we don't know his name, we can write his title as well. His title is Vice Chancellor. This address is usually placed 4 lines below the heading. It is placed usually 4 lines below the heading if a word processor is used. If you are writing your formal letter in your MS Word, so you place your inside address just below the 4 lines of the heading. And on the other hand, if your letter is handwritten, so an inside address should be placed 1 line after the heading, 1 line below the heading. This is the example. Mr. M. Leaf. Leaf is the name of a particular person. And Chief of Seraph Production. This is the title of the particular person. And Old Sticky Pin Cack Company, 456 Maple Lane. This is the address of the person. Now, if you don't know the name of this person, you don't know the name of this person, for example, Mr. Muhammad Leaf, you don't know his or her name, you can skip it and you can directly write his or her title as well. That is Chief of Setup Production, and after that there is address. Another one is salutation. Skip one line after the inside address and write the salutation. Salutation is written after one line. Your choice of salutation depends on whether you know the intended recipient of the formal letter. If you know the recipient of the formal letter, you would know what salutation should be used. The most usual greeting is, most of the time we use this term, dear. It is the most usual greeting. And this greeting, the most usual greeting, dear, is followed by the person's name, and punctuated with a colon. After the name of the person, we use this colon after the name of the person. But if you don't know the name of the recipient, then what should you do? What would you write? Let's discuss it. If you don't know whether the person you are addressing, if you don't know whether the person you are addressing is a man or a woman, if you don't know, if you are not sure about the gender of your recipient, you may begin with dear Mr., dear Sir, or Madam, against punctuated with a colon. You can start salutation with dear Sir or dear Ma'am. You can write dear Sir or dear Ma'am, and punctuated with a colon. Put colon after dear Sir or dear Ma'am. Miss may be used if you do not know the marital status of a woman. If you don't know the marital status of a woman, you should use just Ms. Ms. means Miss. Furthermore, if the person has a specific title such as doctor, etc., make sure use it. If the person has a specific title, for example, you are not sure about the marital status of a woman, but you know that she is a doctor, so instead of writing Miss, you can write doctor. Like dear Mr. Trunk, dear Miss Root, and dear Mrs. Branch. Now this shows that the woman is married. It shows that the woman is married and she is the wife of Mr. Branch. And you can also use doctor, because when you know that the person is doctor, so you should use doctor instead of Mr. or Miss. And you should put colon after it. After that, we have body. After salutation, we have body. Skip one line after the salutation. You need to skip one line after the salutation and begin writing the body of your formal letter. This is the main part of the letter. This is the main part of the letter where you discuss, where you present your important points. It is best to use short sentences, short paragraphs, clear paragraphs, and logical paragraphs to state your business, to state your purpose. So use short paragraphs and concise paragraphs in order to state your purpose. And the last part of a formal letter is closing and signature. This is the end of the letter. This is the very end of the letter. Now, what should you do? Where should it be written? It should be written just one line after the main body of your paragraph. So skip one line after the last paragraph of the body of the letter and write the closing. Skip one line after the last paragraph of the letter. Only the first word of the closing would be capitalized. Not all words would be capitalized. Just the first word of the closing would be capitalized. It is punctuated with a comma. It is, and this is also important point, it is punctuated with a comma. Now leave several lines after the closing and type or print your signature. You can type your signature and you can print your signature using ink. Write your actual handwritten signature between these two printed lines. Like there is an example, yours sincerely, you write your sincerely, and after that put comma, and then your signature, and then your name. The in between these, this is the signature. Like you can write your signature over here. These are the references. So in today's class we discussed what is formal letter, and we discussed the different parts of formal letter. We discussed the uses of formal letter. We discussed the different parts such as heading. We discussed what do we write in heading part of the formal letter. What do we discuss in the inside address? What we discuss in what we write in salutation, and what do we write in body of formal letter, and what do we write at the end of a formal letter? That is closing. Thank you very much for listening to the video. Allah Hafiz.